genome, genome book by Matt Ridley. Arun bhai, I want like you to tell us why this book is important to understand the karma theory. Arun bhai.
As per karma theory, all the fruition of karma takes place at the subtle level of human existence. With the research today, we know very well that each cell, and at the nucleus of each cell, we have a database, DNA. Approximately 3 billion genetic codes are available in each cell. Our body is made up of 50 trillion cells. But this each cell will produce, at the nucleus it produces, certain microchemical compounds, microorganic chemical compounds, and these chemical compounds in general are the messages given to the cell, and together each cell will produce different, these messages can be converted into activities through these messages. And according to that, we do all our mental, vocal and physical activities. Even for good activities and bad activities, these messages are coming. Now, if you can match this thing with karma theory also, where is Atma? Atma is throughout our body. Atma is in our live cells, and these live cells and Atma are associated with karmic particles. It is very well explained by Lord Mahavir that whatever the shape of the body, whatever the size of the body, according to that, Atma Pradesha are spread throughout. That is in each cell, in our scientific language. So, these messages which are coming are producing this microorganic chemical compound with a definite message, and that is message of the karma. And according to do activity, the moment we do activities, we attract other karmic matter, and according to that we make our future program. So this is what is happening. But then if we try to understand very well through such books like genome, these are all scientific research what is going on. And according to that research, we know very well that these programs which are coming are such chemical compounds which give message to our bloodstream. And if we do meditation process by which we can produce these antidotes, the method of meditation, if we understand very well, then we have to do this anupreksha, bhavana, and we have to influence with our willpower and with our practice each cell and transform these messages positively by giving positive suggestions to each part of our body, each cell of our body. And that's why it is so well explained that we have to do meditation, we have to imagine and visualize such frequencies of light which can match the resonance of Atmic Shakti. And then if we do that properly, we will be able to change these messages. But this should be so strong enough. If you do it properly, knowing all the steps properly, and if you do thoroughly, then it will influence. And you can realize this only from your practice. The change, whatever comes. For example, if you are a short-tempered person, you become angry every now and then. But after doing this practice regularly, if you find difference in yourself, you are the best judge of yourself. If you find the difference that the intensity is lower, I am not now anymore short-tempered, but I can control to a certain level. So that difference is the feedback, and that's how you come to know about it. Right?
Thank you.